Evening everyone, for everyone watching in India and for everybody outside, good morning, good afternoon, good day, wherever you are, good evening. So warm welcome to your Wake Up Women series, and this is with Monica BV today, and she is from Bangalore, a 32-year-old woman, a professional, she's married, has a daughter. And when we spoke, she said that she has gone through a roller coaster ride with her finances. But she thought that she would want to now disguise angels and prove to herself and everybody around that wherever you come from doesn't matter. What you do now in your life, in the present, is what defines your future. So that's Monica BV for you, and she's saying that she came in so that she can give her family financial stability and help her daughter become financially educated from now onwards. So today, a professional, a mother, a woman who is earning well, a woman who knew nothing about finances, but today is confidently teaching her daughter about it. So today, that's Monica, and today she is coming in. So let's bring her on, and everybody who's around, do acknowledge your presence. I would love to know that you are around and that you're listening and you are allowing yourself to be inspired by each woman who comes in week after week. So do acknowledge that you are around. Hi Diksha, welcome. I am so glad you've already acknowledged even before I said. Thank you so much. Monica, if you're around, let me know so that I can bring you in, and you can send a request to join the live too. Hi Nihara, Arokya, welcome. Okay, request Monica, please see if you can find it. Warm welcome my people, what an absolute privilege having you on this beautiful morning, evening, afternoon, wherever you are in whichever city, country. Hi Monica, welcome.
Hello, hi.
Hi. Okay, you've gone.
My.
Yes, that's the perfect. Got it. Yes, please settle down, and thank you so much, Monica, for giving us your time. What I wanna say, you know, time is something which is really, really precious for me. And what I know is that this time that you're spending with us, you are never going to get it back. So thank you so much for your generosity of coming in and really sharing your time with us, because I know even you will never get it back. I ain't going to get it back. Everybody watching ain't going to get it back. So yes, time is of essence. Thank you so much. Over to you, Monica. Please share a bit about yourself first. Go ahead.
First of all, thanks for inviting me in.
Thank you.
Right. So I have been born and brought up in a very conservative family where money is treated, you know, something, you know, it's hard to reach, or it's hard to make, it's not grown on trees or anything. You go ask your father, like, do you need it now? I was the youngest kid in the family, and, you know, being a well-to-do family, also that conservative thinking about the money.
Right.
And all of it. It was tough, you know. Since I can remember, it was always tough. Thoughts about money were like, it's tough.
Okay. And what was it? Like earning money is tough, retaining money is tough, growing money is tough.
Even thinking about it, it's like, oh no.
Okay, it's like a deal.
Yeah, it was never openly discussed, you know, even with my mother, honestly, right? It was like a man staying in the family, and you don't understand all this. And I grew up seeing all of it. And there came a point where the business losses happened, and, you know, we were like from very highs to very lows.
Right.
And all I could infer at that age was never trust money. Oh. So that's all I could think of. Yeah, it's never stable, never trust money. And I have to hold on to money so badly that, you know, it never escapes me.
Like, really, hold it tight. Like, yeah. don't let it go.
Yeah. Don't let it go. It'll run away from me. Yeah, and And all of it. Then after my graduation, I started earning. I started earning quite well. Then it was like, you know, it was like that freedom that okay, I have money now, I can do anything. And
Right.
I never the thought of savings or something never really came up. It's all about, you know, you live paycheck to paycheck. You earn quite well. You have this lavish life. Go on.
Got it.
And
Got
with
it.
my marriage came
Yeah.
the biggest, it was like you really aren't responsible for anything. And there came a point when I got married that yes, you're responsible for everything. You have to take charge.
Right. Okay.
Right.
Post-marriage,
So,
like, it wasn't that conservative. It was like you got to take charge now, Monica. That
yes,
was
I did. My
wow.
husband was supportive that way, you know, financial matters. He was open
I'm
to
glad.
discuss about it. It's like, yes, I am very, you know, very lucky that way. I can say that, you know, he was never conservative about money discussions or whatever, and he never shied away giving, you know, charges to me that
Right.
yes, you can take it or you can handle it.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, got it. But
Yeah.
what was the shock after marriage? Like when you're saying it was a shock after marriage, so he's expecting you to not take charge, which of course is a cultural shock, right? Given from the family background you come in. But then what more
Right.
was a shock, please? Yes.
It's about, you know, taking care of the family or the responsibilities which I could even never think of. A
Right.
lot of things, you know, take care and you know, you have this, you have to, you know, make some property or build a house and settle down.
Right.
Lot of thoughts like this, you know, we literally started jotting down. We didn't call it goals, we called it wish list.
Okay,
So
so you and your husband created this wish list?
wish list, yes. So that, you know, we started checking them out, not really working on them, but then yes, we would need such things. We
Right.
might need such these things in future. Later,
Right.
my daughter was born, everything was going fine, it was good. And you know, when I conceived for the second time, it was like, okay, am I really doing enough? Now is fine, you know, my kid is also 7 year old, that is going good. So what next? Am I
Right.
planning it well? What is happening with me? So that is when, at that time, you know, I also came across, I don't know if I really, you know, the laws of manifestation or the laws of attraction. Really, you know, when you seek something, you get it. You
Yes.
know, there is some way you reach there. So that
Right.
is when I came across, and I was browsing through Insta, I came across Women on Wealth. There was a free webinar which I registered to. So
Got it.
once that was done, and you
Yeah.
know, Sheetal was the one who pushed me into the webinar. And a big shout out to Hira Iyer. If it was not for her, I wouldn't be sitting here today. Right.
Awesome.
And
Awesome.
right,
Yes.
you know, after that first webinar, I had no doubt. Okay. I was the first person in that batch to register. Like, okay, there is
Wow.
no looking back from here.
Wow.
Like there are a lot of big breakthroughs. Really, I know in 2 months, it's been 2 months since my money gym and stocks program. In 2 months where I am, it's too, you know, the leap I have taken,
Wow.
which I couldn't do in the past 9 or 10 years. I have done it in 2 months. Like really, can money do so much? I mean, I'm not, I mean, in 2 months my salary did not double anyway, but the things I've done in 2 months, it's like wow.
You know, I want to repeat this because I'm getting goosebumps, like literally, Monica, with what you're sharing. You're saying 9 to 10 years, what you couldn't do, you've achieved that in 2 years on the same salary, like your salary didn't double.
I can proudly say in 2 months I have done, you know, lot of things.
Wow,
And
I
this is,
am so proud of you. You must know that.
yes. And you know,
Beat
still it's a in progress
more.
thing, but yeah, it is still in progress. I mean, I haven't completely adapted to the system yet, but then
Yes.
yeah, like I said, you know, where I was, where I am today, it's a lot. It's a
So
lot.
can you say more? Like what didn't happen in that 9, 10 year period, which you have accomplished in these 2 months? Could you say more on that, Monica?
Like when you said, okay, financial pillars, what are these? You know, having a simple insurance, which you cannot even think of,
Right.
right? And emergency funds, health insurance for your family. You said, okay, you know, though you have your office insurances, still you need to have that, you know, that emergency situations which you cannot even think of because you earn. I always think I earn well. I don't have to worry about the emergency situation. But, you know, after this program, I don't know, it can happen to anyone. Emergency situations can come in.
Right. Okay, so being prepared for emergencies, having the insurance concepts clear and buying the right insurances, health insurances, and not purely dependent on the corporate insurance that you have. Yeah.
Right. And also this, you know, conventional ways of investing for FD or RD, we could never think of anything beyond that.
Right.
Like after that, you know, really me getting into the market and buying stocks, that is something for me, honestly. And mutual funds also. And I've crossed mutual funds, I've bought stocks.
Wow.
So understanding that market cycle and all of it, right? And never I could think of that I can do such things.
Right. Like, you know, I want to say this, and I love this word, you know, you're doing the unthinkable, like something that you couldn't even think that you can do. And, you know, one of my mentors used to say, and I want to say that to you, Monica, you know, you are more intelligent than you think. So, and sometimes, you know, we just amaze our own selves with that, right? That, oh, yeah, I can do this. Oh, my God.
Yeah,
and
how is it even
possible? You were saying something.
Right. It's about, you know, I wonder that, did I do all this? I mean, I didn't take too much time to do all this. It's like in months.
Yes. Like sometimes we think that, oh my God, you know, wealth creation is such a big thing and it's going to take so much time. But it's really the commitment that drives it.
Commitment.
Yeah. Absolutely. Could you share, you know, and another thing I want to acknowledge you for, like when you said, I can't believe that I am, you know, I am in this market, that I am investing in these modern investments. Man, you make me proud.
Correct.
Yeah. Because Monica, you don't know how many women you would be inspiring just by saying that one line, right? Wow. So now with, you know, all the investments done, insurances bought, emergency fund, you know, put together, and you altering your mindset, right? That, hey, you know, emergency can come into every person's life and you don't have to stick just with traditional investments, conventional investments. You can actually go for all these modern investments. And you know, you and I together have discovered your financial intelligence. Now what next? And before next, okay, I want to know, how are you feeling now about yourself?
I am feeling very confident. I mean, I never thought, you know, money, I could go anywhere. Now that I know, I mean, see, when we say that, you know, what would you want to be in 20 years? Never would be even think of it. So while with the system, yes, I could think of it. And somewhere, you know, if not there, I always say, try to reach the stars, at least you can reach the sky.
Wow.
So if not there, you know, you reach somewhere, you know, instead of staying on the ground, you reach somewhere, you're trying to reach there.
Got it.
So all things, now I know what I have to reach, where I have to go, and, you know, how my kids' future have to be, and what is the plans that I have to do for them, how to make them financially, you know, stable, not thinking, you know, not being very conservative about money, openly discuss with them. So that they really know that, you know, this is not something, it's not a taboo. Money is not a taboo topic.
Wow.
We can discuss about it openly.
I want to acknowledge you, Monica. Most of us, you know, unconsciously, we adopt how our parents spoke, right? The culture that they had with us. And, you know, you've broken all those barriers. You're no more living your dad's limitations or your mom's limitations. You've kind of broken out and you're now openly discussing money. Wow. What a big thing that is. Like, really. And I trust you get this, you know, you get the magnanimity of this. Because if each household can, you know, do what you're doing in your house, trust you me, our children, our future generation is going to be something extremely different.
Correct. Wow.
And how is your husband responding to all the changes now?
I mean, I don't see any change because he's always been supportive. So he's continuing his support which I'm happy with.
Okay.
And the community support I get, right? I mean, I was really in awe saying, you know, really can women support each other so much? Because either, you know, we are conditioned in such a way that get jealous of someone who's doing really well, or, you know, how can she get that which I can't get? In all of it. And when I see this blog community, right, I was like, the sisterhood is the word that comes to me, you know, seriously. How can women support each other so much without you know, judgment and all of it?
Right.
Seriously, it's so genuine. The tips we get or the guidance we get from the community, it's like wow.
Yeah.
And that is why this community is wow.
Yes, and I know the competitive world you're talking about, where, you know, it's about, okay, she made it there, let me get in there. I mean, all the professional world that we come in from.
Right.
Yeah. And I think, you know, there's a very different way we need to really look at our own selves and each other, and bang on, you know, you just summed it up by saying sisterhood. Yeah. Because,
right.
Yeah. That just sums us up. We are family. We are all one.
Right.
And
pull each other up instead of, you know, putting everyone else down and me reaching there. Let's pull everyone else with us.
Yeah, and it'll be fun together. Akele mein to kya hi maza aayega, Monica. So,
right.
Yeah.
And you know, when we talk about the sector studies or the company studies, I mean, doing it alone is like you can't even think of it.
Yeah.
You know, with the community support and you know such things, it's like really good to have that community support.
Got it. So community is our queen. It's our queen,
yes.
It's our king. Absolutely.
True.
And how are you teaching your daughter, you know, your second child? I don't know, whether it's a son, daughter, how is it?
Okay, second one, God had better plans for me. I had to give up on that pregnancy. So,
okay.
Fingers crossed, but there's
okay.
Something better coming up.
Yeah,
but
yes.
My daughter, like, I try and explain to her, you know, how money works, how she has to save things, you know.
Okay.
How is it? For now, it's like piggy bank and savings for her. But then, yeah, she's just 7.
Okay,
so
she's already saving money in her piggy bank, huh?
Yes, she wants to buy a scooter for her college, so she's saving her money for that.
Wow, how old is she now, Monica?
She's 7. She's 7.
Wow, so she has a goal which is 11 years apart.
Apart, yes. She wants to buy a scooter and she's saving on that.
Man, kudos
so,
to you. You already made your daughter a visionary, because, you know, like how you're helping your child think 11 years ahead and saying,
yeah.
Okay, you want that, then do it.
Right.
So you're actually helping her, you know, see a vision for herself, something that she wants, and you're empowering herself and enabling herself on how she can do it by herself.
Right. Right.
So already she's learning planning and action and
and more of me teaching her directly. It's like, you know, it comes from she's seeing me watching these videos. You know, I never miss a video on Women on Wealth.
Okay.
So always when I'm on my phone, she's always next to me. So
wow. Right. Okay, I think we've lost Monica, but I am really amazed that yes, you know, yeah, kids are right around us and they learn more from what we do than what we tell them to do. And here, because Monica is watching the videos herself and the daughter is right next.
My bad.
You know, Monica, I was just saying that your daughter is, you know, ongoingly listening. And I think that is what is going to further, you know, build the skills in already.
Right. It's not like me directly teaching her.
Right.
Or maybe the sheets I work on, you know, she just sees what am I doing, where am I, or what is it I'm working on, and the videos I watch.
Right.
And with the research I am doing with the market and all that, she asks me, what is this? What are you doing with this?
Right.
You know, such things, maybe somewhere in the back of her mind it stays, and somewhere it will be helpful for her later.
Wow. More power to you. Thank you for bringing our daughter, our country's daughter, like this. I think if
yes,
each daughter can be brought
mind.
Up. Yeah, I want to say this, Monica. If each daughter can be brought up like that, man, you know, the women's empowerment, women's issues won't exist, is how I see it. Like, really how I see it. Thank you for doing
right.
what you're doing. Yeah, this really
yeah.
counts. And
The only
I
thing
must
I
tell
want
you,
to
look
tell you,
out.
it shouldn't be like us, you know, always being conservative, or, you know, is it, you know, to talk about, to discuss about certain things. It's like being a girl, you're not supposed to do that. That should not be the thing with the next generation.
Oh yes, this bullshit, I must say, has to stop. We really need to stop this. Right? Because I think any one of us can do anything that we want. Yeah. Let me see what some of you are saying. Kavita is saying such nice takeaway points. Good to see you, Monica, after a long while. Kavita, thank you so much for jumping in. Nidhi is saying, great thought process. Nidhi, thank you for coming and really listening and sharing. This counts. You count. Each one of you counts. Hi, Ruchi. Welcome. Okay, it seems I have lost Monica. I'm going to bring her back for her final thoughts. But meanwhile, please start typing. What are you guys getting? What are you learning? Because I'm sure there is some bit that you can take away from each conversation. Hi, Raksha. Welcome. Okay. So start typing, everybody. I am bringing Monica back and I want to hear from each one. What is it you got? You know, today, another time I'm getting present to that, man, we're changing this world together. It's only together that we can change this world. And I think bit by bit, day by day, we're changing it. Monica, welcome back.
Thank you. I think there was a network issue. Sorry.
Yes, please. So your final thoughts. Before you leave, please share. What are your final thoughts? What is it that you want to leave the Women on Wealth community with?
Yeah, definitely don't shy away from money or finances. We can take charge. We can handle anything. Right.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's always like, you know, we shy away or, you know, really worry about going ahead, because if we mess it up, we get to hear from a lot of places. So just don't shy away. It's like, take charge of your finances.
Yes.
And be confident is one thing I can say with the finances or with anything else. Be confident, you know, even to speak up anywhere, we might think twice. Let's not do that. When
yeah.
we have thoughts, let's put it across.
Yeah, and we are safe in this world, you know. We're safe, you know. We're safe in sharing what we want to share. We are really safe. Thank you so much, Monica. This was big. And I will now share some of the comments that our community is saying some things. Tarita is saying, that's wonderful, Monica. You are bringing up your daughter so well. Great job. Yes, great job to each mother in the Women on Wealth community who is bringing her daughter, her son, like this. Absolutely. Sarita, you rock. And Monica, you must know what a great job you're doing.
Thank you.
Manisha is saying, I'm watching live video for the first time. Few weeks ago only I joined this group. It's really great the way Monica is teaching her daughter. Thank you, Manisha. Thank you so much for coming in, joining in, and today acknowledging. So thank you so much, Monica, for coming in. Keep coming back. Okay? I want to keep hearing about your progress. So keep coming back to the Wake Up Women series, and I want to share more. And I am sending you abundance of love, wealth and wisdom to you,
Same
to
here.
Your daughter, to your husband and the coming child, and everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming.
Pleasure being here.
And everybody who's listening, keep coming. This is what's possible when you come and acknowledge your sisters around you in this community. Loads of love. Take charge. Stay safe. Monica, thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you.